Hello friends, my name is Arvind. Welcome to Creamy Learner. Today in this video, I am going to introduce you to a plugin which is Codota named. This is its official website. What it says, AI completion for your Java IDE. So just to summarize what is Codota. So when you are coding, so first some piece of codes which are repetitive and you those are obvious, but still you have to write those, you have to type those, right? So what does Codota? It inspects those code, predicts and learns what are the by defaults, what are the most used one, then recommends to use those default codes, right, which are most used. So basically it automatically completes the code for you which are obvious and by default and which are which must be used, and right, so you do not have to write repetitive code. This Codota plugin will do for us. Okay, so this makes life of developer easy, right, by writing less on IDE. Okay, so it adds productivity. So what further it says, Codota faster code, faster and smart using code completion, learn from millions of program directly. It supports IntelliJ, Android Studio and Eclipse. These are the three IDEs where you can use this Codota plugin. Okay, so these are the few more things that you can go through. Full line AI autocomplete. So before going and integrating it to IntelliJ IDEA and show you, I want to introduce a new concept. I got it when I was researching through this Codota. Example centric programming. What is this? Just let's go through this Wikipedia page. Example centric programming is an approach to software development that helps the user to create software by locating and modifying small examples into a larger whole that I just told you. Okay, so it detects the by default and most obvious codes that you are going to type and does auto completion for you. So that approach can be helped by tools that allow an IDE to show code examples or API documentation. So when you are writing the code, so what do you do when you are using some public library? You go through the documentation of that. So by this example centric programming, you write the name of the API and it then suggests you what to use. So do not need to go all the time to documentation, which happens to be always a huge document, right, and difficult to go through all the things. So this is the main thing. Okay, so this is the background, this is the page that you can go through, but I am skipping to just important one. And background is this here, and just benefit, what benefits it give, prevention of usage errors. So when you type the code, there may be some chances of errors, right, so it reduces that. Reduction of time searching for code examples, correct. Reduction of time searching for API documentation, most obvious. Clarification of existing knowledge and reminding of forgotten details. So what you are going to use, that comes, but in addition to that, it also suggests other things which you can keep in your memory or something. You don't need to remember, it will just show you. Okay, so emergent programming, you can go through it. So these are the examples which provide this example centered programming. This is the blueprint. Blueprint is a plugin for Adobe Flash Builder, right? This is the red print is browser based development environment for PHP programming language. Okay, there is Codex is available, knowledge base that records common practices for Ruby. Okay, this is applicable for Ruby. Codelet is there, code in interactive helper widget that assists the user in understanding and integrating the example. Binge code search is there, and here comes Codota. Okay, which we are interested, and I'm going to show you. Codota helps developers find typical Java code examples by analyzing millions of code snippets available on sites such as GitHub, Stack Overflow. It analyzes. So what the codes that are available publicly, it analyzes those and generates the predictive models and suggests based on that. So it doesn't take the code that you have in your machine, but from the publicly available code that generates it. Codota ranks these examples by criteria such as commonality of the coding patterns, credibility of the origin, and clarity of the code. Correct? The Codota plugin for IntelliJ IDEA and Android Studio allows developers to get code examples for using Java and Android APIs. Okay, so let's move ahead and integrate this Codota plugin in our IntelliJ IDE. Okay, so I already have opened this IntelliJ IDE. So what you have to do, go to File and then Setting. Keep in mind the steps. Okay, so here plugin is by default coming because already I had searched for it. If it is not coming in your case, you just go to this search bar and search for plugin. Okay, so you will see this, these all windows coming, so this will be highlighted here, so you will get this plugin. Correct? So here there are three options: marketplace, installed, and updates. Okay, so under installed, what are already available in your IDE? Those are here. So Android support, and support, bytecode viewer, copyright coverage, all these are available in my IntelliJ IDE already installed plugin. Okay, so updates. If there is any update in the existing plugins which are installed, I can check here for the updates. And this is the important marketplace where you can install new plugins that are available. So these are the different plugins available that you can see. We are interested in Codota, so just search it and you will see the recommendation and click it. Codota, and you get this right. So you can go through the summary that they have given here, right? So these are the description. So I'll go ahead and install this. Okay, using third party. This is the warning that it is showing, and you can just accept it. Okay, so it is downloading and installing. So installation is complete, and I have to restart the IDE to work it properly. So just do it. Restart. Yes, yeah, correct. Do it. So it is just going and restarting my IntelliJ IDEA. So it is. I personally have found this Codota plugin really helpful, which helps me in auto completing the when I am using Java libraries like collections and Java 8 related things like Lambda, optionals, and all those things. So it helps me in auto completing all those codes which earlier I had to write manually. So your Codota option, you will see you are almost done. Connect to complete the installation. You have to log in it, log into the Codota, and it will give you a code that you have to sign in. So you can go ahead and connect using Google, and any of the option you can choose for. So I'll go ahead with connect using Google. So this I'll go ahead with my account. Okay, I already have created account, so I just need to log in it. So logging you, this will show you this window, logging you automatically. Okay, so this has logged in automatically. That is why next option are coming. Return to your IDE to start using Codota. So it is saying you, so just come to IDE. Yeah, I got it, right? So these are the options that it is showing tip that. Okay, so just close it. Okay, so Codota, it is saying me welcomes page is there, and it is some recommendation is also showing how can I use it. And this is the tab that I can see along with Maven and Codota, and anytime I can go here and see the things, right? So let me create some class and see this Codota in action. So I'm going ahead and creating a new class, Java class, Codota demo. I have got this class, right? Now write the main method PSVM. So this is the template that I can write, that I can select PSVM. Okay, so this is shortcut for writing the main method. I do not have to write public static void. So this doesn't come from Codota. This is from IntelliJ IDE itself. So Codota is yet to come. So suppose I want to just write any Java available API. Suppose I want to use list, okay, so list I write. And Codota comes into, so just import this. So for import, just press Alt Enter, that it is showing you. So it will import, show you the option, what are the list that you want. So I want java.util. So Codota comes into action when you press equal assignment operator, then Codota will come in action, right? You can see, so this is the green color icon that you see. These are the different recommendation that is coming, new linked list. So what was the case earlier? You had to write what list you wanted, you had to write, right? New array list, new linked list, what you wanted. Here it is showing me the recommendation. I can go for anyone here, array list as object, array list, linked list, collections, empty list. So let me go ahead with new array list. Okay, so it completes the code for me. So this was the one example. So let's go ahead and do something with list. Okay, so if I list dot add, so list, I press the add and it is showing me the different recommendations. So this green color icon is from Codota. If I press add, so it is asking me to add the element, something I want to add, I can add it here, this. So you see, if I am some input stream reader, which is for taking input from the system, if I write this and ISR, and the moment I type equal, it will show me the auto completion, new input stream reader, input stream, in what option I want, I can go ahead with that. So suppose I want first one, so see, it completes the code for me in very nice way. It has created a variable IN for me of type input stream, which I needed to pass it inside this constructor, and now I can initialize this, okay, and I can give it to value. Okay, so this is again showing me the different options, right? Backtrack, I can go, I can, this is really nice, right? You see the code, you press equal and you see the recommendation, right? So sometimes it happens that you press, you typed equal, but the recommendation is not coming. In that case, in Windows, you can type control plus space, control plus space, the auto recommendation will get populated here, right? So I can go ahead with new file name here also. So see, nice path name variable it has created for me, and now I can go ahead and write the string, right? So this is the option that is really nice. So see, list variable, it is using that I already have created, and it is using the really nice syntax, which is Java it stream and then collect and then joining all those stuff. So let's go ahead with this auto recommendation, right? So that's really nice. So just click on, so it need to have this cast to string, because see what exception it is showing. Yeah, because it, we have not used any generic thing here, that is why it is of object type. So it, that is why it is asking me to cast one, cast to that type. So if I have created list of a string, so that's not a problem. So now I have path name, right? So new file input stream, it is also showing some error. So these errors, that red lines you are coming, these are coming from the IntelliJ IDE itself. Okay, so what is coming from Codota, you will see this icon, green color icon. Okay, so you can inspect, you can differentiate what is coming from IDE and what is coming from Codota. Add exception, actually this throw file input stream throws an exception, so you need to take care of that. So I hope it is clear to you how to use Codota. So Codota, if you have written your custom classes in your file, that auto completion I think doesn't work for that. Let's see that in action. Suppose I have created this main class here, okay, and there are some methods here, just make it public so that I can access it. Okay, let me access this main, let me create the object of this main class here. Main, okay, main, and then equal. So Codota is just control plus space. So Codota is not working in this case, okay, because it is your own private code and it does not have knowledge about that. So it has knowledge about the publicly available code, right, like Java library and other libraries, Spring Boot, Apache and other stuffs, so that it works with those ones. So here you have to create the main class manually. Now it is coming from IntelliJ, which one to use, okay. So there is some kind of intelligence in IntelliJ IDEA itself, so it does that also, but Codota is at advanced level that does that we just saw. So new main, and I can go ahead and just call some method and equals hash code and whatever goes there, okay. Outer list function, anything I can do it, okay. So just skip it because Codota, it is not applicable to Codota, so not sense, not much sense. So one more thing, suppose you want some information about some API, because it says that you do not, you do not, don't have to go in documentation in detail. So what you have to do, suppose you have a string builder class, right, you just write it, okay, and just right click here. There is some, it shows some example, new Codota example, right? If you right click here and go down under down in the option section, so you see get relevant examples, and it also showing you the shortcut that we can use, Control Shift O. Just select it and you will see the relevant examples that you can do with the string builder, relevant examples, right? So string, to string, result, new string builder, it is showing you, yeah, right. So you can see the nice examples here. It is also showing you the popular methods, append, you can go ahead with this. So it's really nice. You do not have to go to internet and search for the examples. It is available in your IDE itself by just installing this Codota. Okay, so that's it for Codota part. I think you go ahead and experiment with this. One more thing I want to show, just go to their official website if you want to explore more, and go their FAQ section, you will get more information. What does Codota do for me? How do I trigger Codota's AI autocomplete that I showed you? Get code examples, what language does Codota support, what operating system can run, what information send to your server, so it doesn't serve, it doesn't send your personal code to Codota server, right, that I told you. So you go ahead with this fact. So these are very few and very nice documentation. So here is a blog also that you can refer to, and here also search for Java code, it's also very nice one. You just write, if you want to see the some examples, suppose I want the examples of list, okay, so it is looking for list and it shows me the examples and Codota and thing what is to do with this. So yeah, list, I'll move my list and link list that I showed you in the IDE just, okay. So it's a really cool thing, go ahead and experiment this Codota, and let me know in the comment section if you have any doubt or concern in setting up this Codota in your IntelliJ or any other IDE. I'll be really happy to help you. Thank you and see you in the next session. Bye bye.